Hello friends, welcome to my channel. The topic to be discussed in this video lecture is self-induction. So now this is self-induction. So like our mutual induction, in the mutual induction we need two coil, okay, but in the self-induction we need only one coil, and the other process are same as my mutual induction. So in that case the current is increases. This, suppose this is my current. Okay, so when the current is increases, it means my induced EMF is also increases, because the flux current is increases means flux lines are increases, and this flux create the induced EMF. So in that case we can say this is a self-induced EMF. Okay, so this is self-induced EMF. So when the self-induced EMF is increases, then it tries to opposes the change in the flux. So this is basically the self-induction. So in self-induction, the coil creates, it means the coil create induced EMF by its own circuit. So what is the definition? The definition is just like that. So self-induction or inductance of the coil is defined as the property of the coil due to which it opposes the change of the current flowing through it. It means it opposes its change of the current flowing through it. It means if my current is more, then my flux opposes, it means the flux opposes that change. And if the my current is decreasing, then the flux is also tries to increases that current. So it means it is same like my mutual induction, the Faraday's experiment, that when my flux is increasing, then we know that when the flux is increasing, it means my induced EMF is increases, so that induced EMF also increases the induced current, and then that induced current try to opposes the change in the flux. Or we can say that if the current in the coil is increasing, the self-induced EMF produced the coil will opposes the rise of the current. So it means when my current is increasing, then the self-induced current is opposes that increase of the current. It means the direction of the induced EMF is opposite to the applied field. So you see, now the my direction is in this direction, then my induced EMF is opposite to the applied field. So it is, maybe it is just like this. So I think you understand. So in case of self-induction, we need only one coil. Okay, and that coil produces the induced EMF by its own circuit. So this EMF, we can say this is the self-induced or self-induced current. So mathematically, how we can write this thing? So we know that our phi is directly proportional to I. Okay, so it means my, if my this phi is increases, it means my current is increases. It means my current is directly proportional to the rate of change of phi. So we can write it is like this: phi equal to L I. So what is L? So L is self inductance, or we can say this is the coefficient of self inductance. So you see, my I is directly proportional to phi, and now we can write phi is equal to Li. So L is the coefficient of self inductance. Okay. So from Faraday's law, we know that from the Faraday's law, what is the formula of Faraday's law? We know that E equal to minus d phi by dt. Okay, so what is the value of the phi? So phi we get from the self-induction is L I. That's why this is L, and that I is d I by dt. So this is my self-induction. So this is the formula for self-induction. So I think you understand what is the difference between the mutual induction and self-induction. So in the mutual induction we need two coil, in the self-induction we need one coil. In the self-induction, that coil and that coil produce the induced EMF by in its own circuit. Okay, so thanks watching this video. Please like and subscribe this channel to get the more updates.